Now we have to write the print invoice module. That is, when the invoice has been generated, the administrator will be taken to a new form where he'll be displayed the data for the invoice, and he will have the option to print. I'll discuss the roadmap and let us see. Basically, we left here print in redirect to action print invoice. So we have to add a print invoice action method and its view. The action method will receive the ID of the invoice that has been generated. Okay, here let us see the roadmap. Okay, consider this schematic. We'll be redirected to this print invoice action method and we'll receive the ID of the newly generated invoice. Here what we'll do is we'll query out the information for the new invoice and pass that data to the print invoice CSHTML form. This page will be displaying a formatted information in a DIV about the invoice and optionally also about the customer to whom the invoice is being made, and it will carry a print button also. Now, as the experienced developers would be knowing that this print has to be handled through your JavaScript, and whatever is inside a DIV that can be printed using JavaScript, I won't go into that code. You have to research that off yourself. So what I'll be doing is I'll be showing the data on a new page. Then you have the option of writing your own JavaScript code for printing the contents of this DIV. It is possible. So the scope of this module is to read this ID and collect the information that has to be shown for a invoice and take the user, that is display, and take this information to the CSHTML view and display it in a formatted manner. We won't be formatting it also. We won't be wiring this JavaScript also. We'll be simply demonstrating that this is possible, and the remainder of the work can be customized as per your needs. Let us start by writing this print invoice action method. It has to be added to the invoice controller and we'll type it somewhere here. Redirect to action print invoice, it is inside the same controller, and here we'll type the story. So we are typing it print invoice, it receives the ID of the invoice to be printed. TBL order will be queried, and since TBL order has attached properties, navigation properties for TBL user and TBL product, we can make use of those navigational properties and include their respective tables also, single or default. So with the TBL order item or the row, we'll also be getting the data for TBL user and TBL product. We could have joined it also, but this is a very handy thing that I have always found. But of course, my recommendations are that whenever you use this type of code, be very careful about optimization, the speed of your code. You will have to do a complete analysis of whether it is better to write this or whether it is better to write the query yourself on the join, because the translations into expression trees, they have their own stories associated with them. So optimization check for a custom for a bigger database you have to do, but for a smaller demonstration we are making use of the built-in story called include. Okay, this will pass everything around an invoice to the view. Here it is. And let us now also add the view. Right click somewhere inside, add view, click add, and we have to now write the code here. We can now type here. It will receive a model of the type TBL order, view bag dot title, printable format. The menu is shown on this page. Then we are adding an action link so that in case the user still wants to edit this invoice, he should be able to go back for editing it. We'll add this later on, edit invoice and all, but we have kept the provision here. And we are also passing a parameter redirect to print invoice so that when he's edited it, he's brought back to the same page. We'll discuss this when we go on to that module, but we have kept that provision here. So here we are writing invoice number, ID auto PK, the ID of the invoice, then dated, the date of the invoice. The date will be Indian format. Why? Because TBL order annotation, we have specified the date to be this one. You can give it any format. We were here. It will honor that format. Then in favor of the name of the beneficiary, his email, comma, his name, then his contact, item purchased, followed by item amount. This is what we are showing on the print page. This one will be a matter of discussion when we go for the edit invoice module. Generally in a project, this provision is can't be kept like that. But you have to remember that this is a tutorial project. So to keep the tutorial flow correct, we have at times added these stories. Otherwise in a real project, when you are writing, nobody can foresee this much. This is a script, and otherwise nobody can foresee, so you will have to ultimately come back and add as per need. Okay, let us run it and see whether our things work correctly or not. I am rebuilding it. Now let us run it. Click to login. And we'll search a customer for whom an invoice is to be generated. IntelliSense will guide us. Search new invoice. We plan to buy a laptop. In India it costs around 20,000 rupees. click save, and we are taken to the printable format. This means our module is working very correctly. Even the print invoice, invoice number, the format is honored in favor of. So formatting is left to you, of course, as I told in the beginning. Print button, etc., you can add yourself. That's a JavaScript story. This edit will not take us anywhere. Click it and you will find resource can't be found. In our next video, we shall be going for the edit invoice module, which is required not only here but also here. For if we search, then you see a stack of edit buttons. This and that both will do the same thing, but the only difference is the redirection. When you click this edit, it will redirect you to this page, and when you do that edit, it will redirect you to that page. That is the only difference that will stay. We'll talk about that in the next video. Thanks.